white, just a little bit of this, yeah, if it is the denim black one, I get it, so, we'll just have to sprinkle it, it isn't much.
No, everything's on the outside, including the cane.
You ever seen glass point gun? Ha! Have it. You know better.
Zed knows I love talking about this stuff and I get really enthusiastic.
Music playing, so that's going to be in the background. You got to have music or else it can't work.
I just listen.
You lose the rhythm.
You just need to know that.
Do you want to pick the cane up out of the box or do you want to do it off the
pad? I'll do it in there. That's how I did it before. I'm just going to keep that. I'll put it in there vertically.
Axial. Is that how you say it?
You guys got this side?
Yeah.
I would think.
It's perfect.
And this is the scale, you're right.
The scale is that I'm just headed to about here. Okay, go over here.
What's going to be big?
Ahead of time, I made these yesterday. These are glass canes. As you can see, the color comes this way. It's whatever in the furnace is just clear glass. And so we add the color later on. So this stuff is called frit, F-R-I-T, which is crushed up colored glass. So yesterday, I took frit on the amber, the orange, the green, and the blue. And so I made these rods, and then this is what we're going to pick up to try to duplicate this pattern, though I'm saying right now it's impossible, because it was done in a freeform style, it's impossible to duplicate, but I'm going to try and hopefully get it as close as possible. Anything that's going to touch the glass has to get preheated to about 1,000 degrees, and the way we do that is put it into that blue oven, which is set at 960 degrees to preheat.
Set it on fire.
So this table is a very important tool, even though it just sits here. It's called a marver, M-A-R-V-E-R. Not only does it hold stuff, obviously, but the metal, it acts like a potter's wheel. I roll the glass back and forth on this to shape it, and the metal also will suck the heat out, so I can control what's hot and what's not.
Red hot, which is what we want. Now we go into the furnace. We gather the first gather of clear glass.
Onto the clear, so I'm going to come on out and walk over to the metal table. And now it's going to act like a potter's wheel. It's going to center up this cylinder to a nice symmetrical shape. And I'm going to blow into it and trap the air in there with my thumb. The air expands, boom, and pushes the glass. So we have a bubble in there now. Stretch out a little bit, it's cooling down. And now I'm going to roll it again. And I'm going to wait, because I'm going to go back in and gather more clear glass. This is not enough material to make the rock the size that we want. So it goes in layers in the last one. We start off with nothing, and then we just build layer upon layer. Cherry wood, it soaks in water 24 hours a day, so that when I put the 2,000 degree glass on here, the wood doesn't burst into flame, the glass just sits on a bed of steam.
I'm going to puff into this a little bit, and then we'll pick up.
Ah, perfect. So this is newspaper. It soaks in water as well. That closest we can get to actually touching the glass. And I'm gonna let this cool down a little bit. Start to expand it.
Stripes.
Yeah, so I'm gonna let this cool down. Then I'll go in there and just heat up the surface till it's tacky. Then I'll go into the blue oven and pick up the colored striped glass canes, is what they're called. And then go back into the furnace and start to melt them onto the surface. And I'm gonna apply the striped colors. And you'll see why it's impossible to completely control how they lay down on the bubble. Now I'm just going to keep heating this up over and over again to be able to mash those glass canes into the surface of the bubble, and then do it over and over again to try to get everything all the same temperature. Now I'm going to go over to the metal table.
On your right edge. And use it to squash. How hard they still are. But eventually,
turning the pipe, because I want to keep everything on center. If I stop turning, gravity will pull it all right to the ground. It's all the consistency of honey right now. Thank you.
staking it on here.
Full body experience. We got everything going. Every sight and smell.
Back.
Every sense.
Yes.
On that one.
Take your time.
close this hole off. And then we can start inflating up this end.
I will soak it. Stop. Nice. Yeah, it's just going to be in the bottom, so it's going to be much more stable this time. To do that again. Try and flatten the sides a little bit on the paper.
So this is like catching a baby?
Yes. From what I hear. I put water where the connection is, which creates a weak spot, chill mark.